Wall Street Week is made possible by grants from Ballhorn Investment. At Ballhorn, your future's in the bag. And High Risk Securities, when you're investing the money you don't absolutely need. And the Diversified Group, your money's safe with us unless the whole thing collapses. Produced Friday, October 23rd. Our panelists are Tony Stepanich, Colin Hutchinson, Jane Wickham, and Stephen Babcock. Our special guest is Future Man.
Good evening, I'm Louis Rukeyser. Well, it's been an up and down week on Wall Street. The bulls, who had ridden the roller coaster to its peak after gorging themselves on the cotton candy of overvalued issues, found themselves Monday caught in a nauseating plummet down the rickety rails of panic selling. And some who stood up on the roller coaster, in spite of repeated warnings, were decapitated. Others who failed to lock the thing that swings down over the waist of fiscal restraint were hurled headlong into the spook house of bankruptcy, all to the eerie strains of the demented calliope that is the federal deficit. Now, that's the kind of week it was. Our first guest is someone who knows a thing or two about roller coaster rides. He is Tony Stepanich, operator of the Wild Moose roller coaster at Playland in Rye, New York. Tony, I want to thank you for helping me with my introductory notes.
Yeah, no problem, Lou.
Also with us is Colin Hutchinson, a partner with the investment firm of Lambert, Fitch & Taylor. Welcome back, Colin. How are you?
I'm fine, Louis. Why wouldn't I be?
Now, Colin, you're advising the small investor to stay in the market.
Well, yeah, there's nothing to be worried about. Everything's going to be fine. This was just a much-needed correction, Louis. Nothing to get upset about. We've been through much worse. What about the Great Depression? That was much, much worse, wasn't it? It's all those guys buying up all those condos on Fifth Avenue. They're probably panicking, but they'd be crazy to sell, wouldn't they?
Well, I think that some of them might have to sell to meet their margin calls.
I know that. Why am I on trial here? It'll bounce back. It's got to. There's too much at stake. Too many people have too much at stake. Louis, you're my friend. Help me.
Yes, yes. All right. Let's turn to someone who is taking a contrary view. Jane Wickham, securities analyst for Siegel & Rhodes. Now, you're a little more bearish than Colin.
Yes, I am, Louis. We're taking a very conservative posture here. This is certainly not a time to panic, okay? Now, we are urging our clients with assets in the market to sell off these assets as quickly as possible for whatever they can get. And we would also urge the small investor to stop by his bank Monday morning, say about 7:30, and withdraw whatever savings he may have tied up in savings account, certificates of deposit, checking, Christmas club, what have you.
Now, wouldn't this tend to cause a run on the banks?
Well, that's why I'm saying to go down bright and early and to tell absolutely no one of their plans.
Well, do you see any sound investments out there?
Yes, Louis. We like bottled water, okay? Canned foods, propane, rural real estate. We're also we're recommending shotguns for defense against the marauding bands of angry inner city youths. I'm frightened, people. Don't you understand this? I'm frightened.
Our next guest.
Don't leave me. Don't leave me.
No,
do you understand? Don't leave me.
I'm right here. I'm right here. Our next guest is, or should I say was, the dean of Whiz Kids on Wall Street. Stephen Babcock is a graduate of Choate, Princeton, the Wharton School of Finance, and at age 24, pioneered the highly controversial practice of trading on margin leveraged options on stock index futures. Now, Stephen, you've suffered every investor's nightmare, losing every cent you own, and yet you seem to be in good spirits.
Well, Louis, following last Monday's carnage,
on the floor. I repaired to a certain Wall Street watering hole where a substantial quantity of liquid refreshment was consumed, and a gratifying level of inebriation was achieved.
Yes. I was sorry to hear about your wife.
Yes, she left me taking certain recreational pharmaceuticals with her. And given my current situation, they would have proved most useful in mood management. However, with the aid of a neighborhood vendor of bottled fluid intoxicants, I was able to maintain a state of profound insobriety throughout the aforementioned ordeal.
So, it is your plan to stay drunk until the market turns around?
Oh, steady as she goes, Lewis.
All right, very well. Now, why don't we go over and meet our special guest? He's a man who has outperformed the market with uncanny regularity. Our visitor from the year 2013, Future Man. A Future Man, your market performance has been nothing short of spectacular, and it is certainly worth reviewing. Now then, you bought here, and then you sold here. And you bought here, bought, sold, bought, sold, bought, sold, bought, sold, unsold. Now, Future Man, what is your basic investment strategy?
Read old newspapers. Go back in time, buy low, sell high.
Mm-hmm. Excellent strategy. Excellent indeed.
Excuse me, would you be so kind as to direct me to the nearest porcelain convenience?
Yes, right that way.
Okay.
Now, Future Man, given the grave state of the marketplace, perhaps you could break precedent and share a hot tip or two with our viewers.
As I have said many times before, I do not give investment advice. Mm-hmm. It would alter history.
Please, Future Man, help me just this once. I won't ask again. Please help me.
Sorry, no can do.
Future Man, will I ever have children?
Well, what was that?
Our inebriated colleague, young Mr. Babcock, just shot himself.
Oh. Now, why didn't you stop him, Future Man?
I didn't like him. I was always glad he killed himself.
Right. Well, I guess our roller coaster ride has jolted to a rather macabre end. I'd like to thank our guests.
Hey, Lou, can I tell you something? The best thing you got happening on this show is Future Man. I don't even know why you book these crybabies. Future Man, that's your show, dude.
Thank you, Tony. Tony, a word of advice.
Yeah.
Get out of the carnival.
Right. Now I'll be seeing you next week, when hopefully the roller coaster will have become a graceful gondola sailing into the tunnel of love that is economic recovery.
Future Man, I'm asking you one more time, please help me. Just please help me.
With you.